Welcome to all of you, both here in person and those of you attending virtually. We welcome everyone across the United States and internationally watching on our website, which is www.stmarksumcsd.org. My name is Connie Eitzen. I'm a co-chair of the Concert Series Committee. We'd like to remind you to silence your cell phones, and also, when leaving the parking lot after the concert, only turn to your right. In your programs, you'll find a concert brochure and a donation envelope. If you've already received a brochure, you can leave any extras in the hymnal racks or with the ushers. Our concerts are free and not supported by our church budget. We will not have an offering, but there are offering plates at each exit from the sanctuary where you can place your donation envelope. Those of you watching virtually can donate online as well. We do have a QR code, and there's also one in your program today. Your contributions would be very much appreciated. We have three concerts coming up in February and March. Friday, February 25th at 7 p.m. is a concert by Sacra Profana here in our sanctuary. Sunday, February 27th at 4:30, we are welcoming Concordia Donna Di Canto and the men's chorus from Concordia College in Irvine. And on Saturday, March 26th at 11 and 12:30, we welcome the San Diego Symphony. And then the other two concerts on our concert series are listed in your program today. Pastor Darren.
Well, I too welcome you to this concert this afternoon, and it is the concert series tradition to open this time with a prayer. So if you feel comfortable to join us, you are invited. Let's pray. Loving God, we are grateful that you continue to draw us together, that you continue to invite us to celebrate the opportunity to be in community, and especially to receive the gifts that you have given certain individuals to bring beauty and inspiration to our lives. Bless these musicians this evening, and bless us all who receive their gifts, that we might remember all of your goodness given especially this day. We pray in Jesus' name, amen.
And now I'd like to introduce our two guests. The duo is comprised of Julie Smith Phillips on the harp and Rose Lombardo playing flute. And they're going to warm your hearts with their musicality. Both are members of the San Diego Symphony, and they will perform selections that enhance the beauty of their instrumental sounds. Ladies.
Good afternoon, and thank you so much for being here. Thank you for everyone streaming online at home or wherever you might be. My name is Julie, and this is Rose, and we are thrilled to be part of your concert series season this year. We're going to open up with an arrangement of a Scarlatti sonata. Scarlatti wrote 555 or so. It's hard to imagine that he was exactly on 555, but that's a great number to have. But he wrote so many keyboard sonatas, and interestingly, most of those keyboard sonatas were all in one tempo. Just a handful of those were in two different tempos, and we are playing one of those unique sonatas for you today. It has two alternating tempos. This was arranged by an arranger, and we have embellished it ourselves. So we hope you enjoy this opening piece, the Scarlatti Sonata in E major. Thank you. Sorry, technical difficulty. Thank you so much. Sorry about the technical difficulties. If I weren't using, I'm to explain what's happening, I'm using an iPad for all of my music, and I don't have enough pedals. I have 7 pedals already. I just decided that wasn't enough, so I add another one to move the pages on my iPad. So, and it's Bluetooth connected, so sadly it just didn't connect at the beginning of the concert, but I think we're good to go now. knock on wood, that it works. I hope you enjoyed that Scarlatti Sonata. It's a lovely, exciting piece, I think. The next piece on the program is the second movement of the Concerto in C Major by Mozart for flute and harp. Now, Mozart, he wrote this a bit earlier in his life. Of course, he started composing, as we all know, from a tender age of maybe 5, I believe. But he wrote this piece when he was in his younger 20s. He was actually in Paris at the time, and he was trying to get out of employment in Salzburg. He decided to travel and try to find employment elsewhere. He was in Paris, and an aristocrat commissioned him to write this piece for himself, the aristocrat, who was an amateur flutist, and his daughter, who was actually a magnificent harpist. Mozart was giving her composition lessons at the time, so he knew her ability on the instrument, he knew her musical strengths, and so he wrote this piece. It's in the popular genre of the time in Paris with the symphony concertante style. And it's actually now one of the cornerstones of our repertoire. So it's very commonly played. We decided to put it on the program because Mozart's birthday was just the other week, 2 weeks ago, and thought it would be a lovely celebration for him. And Rose and I actually got to perform it just last summer at the new opening of The Shell, the San Diego Symphony's new venue. So we thought we'd just bring it back. So this is the second movement of Mozart's Concerto in C Major for flute and harp.
Thank you. Okay, thank you very much. So lovely to see everybody here on this beautiful Sunday. I just want to point out that although we did perform this over the spring, we did have an orchestra with us. And for this performance, Julie very brilliantly filled in all of the orchestra parts on the harp. So she did her own arrangement there, which allows us to play it as just together, just us. So moving on in the program, the next selection that we've chosen for you today is by the French composer of the name Jean Croix. His dates are 1879 to 1932. And he's a prominent French composer, however, his career he spent as a naval officer. And during his service aboard the battleship La Provence in Toulon, he was inspired to write this piece for flute and harp, titled Suite and Duo. And during his travels in Africa, this piece specifically was inspired by the music and nature that he heard while he was in Senegal and Guinea. So you're gonna hear a lot of really interesting modes and melodies that are inspired from, I think the main theme is inspired by the instrument, the balafon, which was kind of like a xylophone. Wooden instrument in Africa that's hit by mallets. And interestingly enough, all of the movements in this piece are composed in the key of A flat for the reason that all of the instruments that he heard in Africa were in the A flat. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you so much. This concert gave us a very special opportunity to arrange those last two Bach selections, so I think we'll add them to our repertoire. they're beautiful. It's Bach. I mean, you can't deny that. So anyways, moving on with our program, we're livening it up a little bit, get some energy back here, and continue on with a piece called Entracht by Jacques Ibert. And this little piece was actually written for a Spanish opera by a French producer, I suppose. Let me see if I can even, I'm not gonna try. It's called The Physician of His Honor is the opera. I don't know that it's still in existence probably, but this piece was soon published after he wrote the interlude for the opera, and has been very popular amongst many different instrument combinations. It can be played with either flute and violin, or harp or guitar. So it's very versatile. Thank you. Thank you. You can definitely hear the Spanish influence in this piece. Ibera was a big fan of the Spanish culture. So this is Entracht, and then we will continue on. You're going to talk about the four.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll play this first. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That piece is very fun to play. So for our final selection today, we've chosen a piece by Gabriel Fauré, another beloved French composer, especially in the flute world. This piece was composed for flute and piano back in 1898. It was commissioned by Paul Taffanel, who is one of the sort of famous grandfather teachers of all of us flutists. We all still every day practice his exercise book that he wrote. It is still the book to practice by. And so during his tenure at the Paris Conservatory, he commissioned quite a few of our prominent flute solo repertoire pieces for the Paris Conservatory annual competition. So these pieces that he would commission, the requirements are for the piece to be very short, but show, let the flutist or in other departments, other instruments, display all of the aspects of playing in a short piece. So tone, phrasing, technique, the whole thing. So this was composed as a competition piece and has since been performed ever since because it's one of our favorite solos to play. And again, it was written for flute and piano. So once again, Julie has so graciously arranged this for harp, which is very impressive. And I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you for the wonderful concert. It's been very enjoyable. Thank you all for coming. Don't forget to turn right out of the parking lot so you don't get a ticket, possibly. And we hope that you will come to some of our other concerts that have been listed. Thank you all for coming.
Thank you so much for coming as well. We enjoyed playing for you very much. Do you want to play one more?
Sure.
Do you have time for one more?
Yes.
There you go. We will allow you to leave with the presence of the meditation from Thais by Massenet.